Oh god, the National Archives.
Oh no.
Oh no, the Dewey Decimal System.
Arizona. April.
Hi, Casey Kasem.
An apprentice accidentally dropped a securing nut into an empty argon tanker and entered the tank to recover it. He took two breaths and collapsed. He died. Oklahoma.
Oklahoma.
A new pipeline in a trench was proof tested with nitrogen. A charge hand entered the trench to investigate an audible leak. He took two breaths and collapsed.
And turned red.
September 26th.
That's a side effect.
After a fire in a pump room was extinguished with CO2, a fireman went down to investigate. He wore an oxygen supply, but as soon as he found the fire was out, he removed his mask. He took
two breaths
and collapsed.
And died.
The fireman died. All these men really died.
All these men look like the same person.
Deadly killer.
He kind of do.
Did not see. There was no warning. They took two breaths, and minutes later,
it was really just
dead.
Episodes
not
of Quantum
so much
Leap.
From something that was there, but from something that wasn't. Oxygen.
Oh my
hey,
gosh.
What's this big deal about oxygen?
That's quite a jump.
Big deal about oxygen.
That's true most of the time, but there are some places.
Okay, I can't breathe underwater.
And there isn't much oxygen at high altitudes either.
So Casey Kasem is like some godlike creature tormenting this poor guy?
Just like in real life.
I do like how this went from he took two breaths and he died to what's the big deal about oxygen?
And someday, someplace, probably where you work every day, and it could be a pipe casing, a ship's hold, a mine shaft, a tank or a pit, usually a confined space of some sort.
Oh,
there's
gosh.
Going to be less than 21% oxygen.
You mean in there? Well, but that looks just like the places I work in or around all the time.
Sure it does. That's why it could be dangerous.
I bet you took two breaths in there.
But I don't smell anything. I don't see anything. I don't hear anything either.
You won't.
Well, so I know if there's oxygen in there.
You won't.
You don't. That's the whole point. If you walk into an oxygen-deficient atmosphere, you won't have a warning.
Why is that question mark scared?
You'll take two
because there's no oxygen in there. It's holding its breath.
Warning or nothing.
That's right.
Yeah, but you mean a few percent less oxygen can actually make a difference?
Usually, it doesn't happen gradually.
But you just said two breaths and you die.
Only 19.5%. Just that much less is the minimum required by law to sustain normal life.
By law!
By law!
Decreases, it rapidly gets dangerous.
Oh, that,
dizziness?
The Green Army man went to the other side. He turned red.
Maybe a headache. Muscular control becomes difficult. Permanent brain damage can occur. Then paralysis. Unconsciousness. Death. In 5 to 8 minutes.
Well, how come there wouldn't be any oxygen in there?
Could be a lot of reasons, George, but mostly because
yeah, hypoxia is actually serious
uses many types of gases. Some of them precisely for the reason that they completely
propane.
Replace oxygen in a
propane. Propane accessories.
Some of these gases are poisonous. Some highly flammable. But many of them you won't see, taste,
I or sell
smell.
Argon and argon accessories.
Lack of oxygen can be caused by flame, fire, rust, or by the decay or fermentation of organic matter.
So, I really don't know what's in there, do I? Oh, hi, Harry.
Oh, George? Harry's gonna take two breaths and die.
Hey, that's Harry in there. He's down. I gotta go get him.
Why is he still smiling?
Think. Don't panic.
Yeah, but there's no
that's a good question.
Time is critical, but if you
Casey
walk in there without oxygen,
Casey Kasem's weekly top 40
so
ways to die.
Help! Harry's down in there. I need an oxygen mask and a safety line, fast.
Now you're thinking. You must have an oxygen source and a lifeline.
All right.
You can't hold your breath long enough to rescue someone.
Yeah, I mean, you have to have one of those if you're going to be a millionaire. Oh.
Oh, hey.
Hey, what happened? I don't remember a thing.
No, you wouldn't, Harry. No oxygen.
Oh, you wouldn't, Harry. We'll see to it personally.
Prevent this kind of thing.
Right. Prevention is the only cure. Be aware of the potentially dangerous oxygen-deficient areas on your job. and plan ahead. Know what you're going to do and check each procedure carefully.
Like,
monitor and test the atmosphere of all areas before you enter. Use a self-contained breathing mask
that is one serious looking face
and always have them available for an emergency. Use lifelines and harnesses and use the buddy system
so both of you can take two breaths and die.
He's dead.
Don't panic, he's just dead.
You need two or more people to help with the rescue.
Don't cry for him, he's already dead.
You must have an oxygen supply and a lifeline with someone on the other end. Don't become the second or third victim.
Oh my god.
Most of all, prevent accidents.
The bodies are piling up.
Don't enter an area of any kind without knowing what have you done? Because oxygen deficiency is waiting for you. And there won't be any warning at all. All you'll have to do is take two breaths to...
You're not going to say it this time?
No, they can only say it when they're talking about... Oh. Oh, hand... Oh. Oh, my.
Is there something I should know about Hanford?
The Hanford site is the location of the world's first nuclear reactor and one of the most polluted sites in the United States.
Oh, my. Yeah.
I mean, it's an important place for this history of, like, energy and stuff, but there's a lot of stuff there.
Probably more stuff than just... Since some stuff will take less than two breaths to die.
You can take no breaths and die.
End of recording, because you're dead.
Two breaths to end recording.